the viewer just wanted the sounds of rubber gloves like these. Basically, washing dishes or just dishwashing gloves and some soft speaking. So, these are the gloves I have. A little closer. They're a little dirty right now. They're decent quality. I used to have a better pair, but I kind of broke them. This is the best way to put it. They look a little dirty and dingy because I use them a lot. But they'll probably get clean. As I wash some dishes. I have this sort of bridge here so that you can grip things a little better. And the rest is nice and smooth. It's good to use these when you're working with hot butter so your hands don't get burned. Also, just to protect your nails and your hands when you're cleaning or washing a lot of dishes. They're very sticky. So let's put them on. Submerge them in the hot soapy water. I am having a brunch tea party in a couple days. So I'm using my grandmother's china, which was given to me. Unfortunately, I don't have a lot of space to keep the stuff. So, that being said, I have them stored in the kitchen. They don't fit in the cabinets, so they go on top. Which means anytime I cook anything with oil, or the oil rises in the air, it evaporates as you cook. Most things that exist, especially porcelain type things or china type things, they will attract all that stickiness and all that oil that evaporates. And then all the dust sticks to that, so the china gets very dirty. And since I'm going to be using this for my party, I need to wash all of it. As you can see, let me see if I can grab one of these. I mean, just look how filthy that is. Just got dirt and dust and grime. Very sticky. The gloves are sticky, but so is this teacup. And this plate, you can see, this one's less dirty. This one actually has a bit of a crack in it. But it'll still work. Maybe I'll get another one for it. Another plate, that is. Put that aside then. Ugh, I mean, just look how filthy. Can you guys see? It gets so gross. Super sticky. So I have all my teacups. And I have all my plates. Sorry about all the shaking. Tools. I have just a regular sponge here. It has has this side for scrubbing and a softer sponge side. And then I've got this little scrubby brush. And this will be good to get any spots that are really grimy. Soapy water. I'm doing this in the bedroom because the lighting in the kitchen is really terrible. So I'm just going to adjust the angle so you guys can see a little bit better. They're sticky gloves. And yeah, we'll adjust the angle and then we'll come on right back. Okay guys, so I changed the angle so you can see my hands and the water a little better. I have my Sudsy water right here, some bubbles, so it's a little hot, so I'm going to get this off of my legs. Hopefully I'll back up a little bit so you can see the water a little better. Okay, some of these cups are really gross, so I'm just going to soaking them. Just give them a moment to absorb the hot water. Get my sponge ready. And behind me, I have a towel laid out so I can put the different dishes to dry. So let's get a plate here to start soaking. Sound sticky anymore. I just have that nice squeaky kind of feel going on. Okay. So, I'm gonna get my sponge wet. Start with this teacup. It seems a little less gross. Take my sponge. Start gently going in circles. Clean it really good so I'm going to get the outside and the inside. China. See, I was born to my grandmother, which is really cool. I'm just going to go in and get this bottom part. Okay, that looks pretty good. smooth, which is great. I see a couple little more spots, so I'm just gonna really scrub in there. What do you guys think? I think that looks pretty clean. It's still soapy, but we'll do another rinse on it later. Okay. I feel pretty good about this one. I'm just going to give it one more look over. Let's mix it up. Let's move to a plate. This plate is just so filthy. I kind of want to save it for last, so you know what? And this was the really filthy cup. I'm going to leave that here too. Let's move on to another plate. See, I have one over here. Make sure this isn't the cracked one. This one already looks fairly clean, but I still want to just make sure. So I'll let it sit in the water for a moment. Scrubbing. It's real nice and soapy, which is great. It always feels nice when you have lots of bubbles. It's got this pretty pattern, doesn't it, this china? These nice flowers. So some of these are going to be a lot easier to clean. I think the plates that were on the bottom are going to be a lot easier. This already looks clean to me, so I'm just going to splash some water on it. Yeah, this feels good to me. I'll just have to rinse off the soap later, but you can see that looks nice and clean. So, let's put that aside. Alright. Oh, I actually have a lot of little plates to do. I have these plates, which have this little ridge, and that's where the teacup is going to rest. So you see there's little plates that go. And I have small plates and medium plates, just for snacks. Let's get this guy going. We're just gonna dip him in, get it nice and wet. Let's get our sponge, nice and soapy. A little hot water, a little elbow grease. All it needs. So, I'm kind of dripping water all over my legs, but I'll just dry off after this video. It'll be fine. Alright, this one feels nice and clean. I hope my movements are still relaxing, even though they're a little fast. I'm hoping it's the sounds that are more of the trigger, as opposed to the visual. about it. It's kind of like a bridal brunch, but very informal. I wanted to have a little thing at my place for a while now. Because I don't have people over very often, since most people don't live where I live. But also my bridesmaids have only met each other. Two of them are college friends, and the rest are high school friends. And one of them is my cousin. He's one of my best friends. My cousin, though, has met my high school friends and college friends, of course. She's been in my life my entire life, so that guy looks good, too. This is actually going a little quicker than I thought. But yeah, so my college friends and high school friends don't know each other very well. They've met once before. Maybe once or twice they've come to a birthday of mine or something. So this is kind of an opportunity for them to get to know each other a little better. I'm really impressed with how clean these ones are. Nice and easy. I think the cups are going to be more difficult. So anyway, like I was saying, I think it'll be really nice, and I love hosting parties because I love doing, like, using cute silverware and, like, plates like this. I love to cook, and I love doing little themes. I just think it's a lot of fun, so I'm kind of going all out. My guest list, I have 6 people confirmed, and 3 maybes. So it's not too many people, which is good because I have a small apartment. But, let's move to a cup. Ooh, this one's real dirty. Let that soak. Actually, these are all dirty, all these cups. Let me try this cup that's been soaking for a bit. Oh, no, he's so gross. Okay. I think I'm going to move. I think I'm going to continue with the plates. Do all the easier stuff first and work on the more intense stuff for last. So these are just plain plates without the dip. And these are just for, you know, small little appetizers or bites. I thought I would have one smaller and one slightly larger. Yeah, different sizes, different options. So anyway, what was I saying? Brunch food, yes. So, I'm going to have kind of little bites, like appetizer brunch items. I'm going to be making little tea sandwiches on a white bread, I think. A vegan white bread without any egg or dairy. Because I am vegan and I only cook and have vegan food in my home, so my friends are all very open-minded though to vegan food, so that's great. So I'm gonna have little tea sandwiches. I'm gonna do a cashew cream cheese I'm gonna make myself, and I'm gonna have that on the white bread with thinly sliced cucumber. I think it'll be really nice. My items. As far as savory goes, I'm also going to have these little deviled eggs. Now you're probably wondering, well, eggs aren't vegan? Maybe you're not wondering that. But I make deviled eggs, I'd say quote unquote deviled eggs, they're actually potatoes. I take little white potatoes that have an egg-like shape. I peel them, and then I cut them in half lengthwise, so they look like a little half egg. This plate's a little more sticky, by the way. This is going to take a little more work. So yeah, I take these potatoes, I roast them, then I scoop out the middle. And so it's kind of like a little bit of potato salad. I do a little bit of black salt, which is actually pink in color. And it has sort of an eggy flavor to it, you could say. So I do that mixed with a little bit of vegan mayo, some chopped onion, a little bit of turmeric to get that color. And I top it with some smoked paprika. And I refill the potatoes. They look like little deviled eggs. They taste a little bit like deviled eggs, but it's really little potatoes, like a potato salad. But I thought those would be really cute. The last time I did a tea party was like, I don't know, almost 5 years ago. And I made those and they were quite a hit. Hard to tell with the gloves on, but I think it feels pretty smooth, so I'm going to put that aside. Okay. Next plate. Anyway, so that's another savory item. What else? I'm also going to make little mini savory scones. I think those will be nice. I'm gonna make them with a little nutritional yeast. Just give it kind of a cheesy flavor. I'm gonna do some chopped scallions in there. I think that's it. Yeah, I don't think I'll put anything else. Some salt, a little pepper maybe. Real basic. Maybe a little dried basil. That might be nice. So, those should be nice and tasty. Ooh, maybe I'll do rosemary. Rosemary would be really nice. I think I'll do a little rosemary in those. What else am I doing savory-wise? I think that's it for the savory food. For sweets, I'm going to make mini sweet scones. I'm thinking maybe like a lemon. I want to do lemon blueberry, but I'm going to make them really small, and I think that it might be a bit weird unless I do the blueberry right on top. It'll be hard to get blueberry all mixed in there. I could also do lavender. That would be nice, I think. But I don't know. We'll see. Lemon lavender, that'd be a nice scone, don't you think? Maybe I'll do that, guys. It'll help me out with these ideas, whether you realize it or not. And then I'm gonna do some little like raw truffles. I think I'll do almond coconut chocolate truffles. Those should be nice. And they're good and bite-sized. I think this plate has been good. I've just been kind of attacking it. I'm going to do mini donuts. Do chocolate donuts with an icing over it. I think those will be really tasty. And then I think that's it for my sweets. I'll have some fresh fruit, like a fruit salad. That should be good though, right? Let's see. Deviled potatoes. Savory scones. Donuts, truffles, and sweet scones. Oh, and cucumber sandwiches. Yeah. In my mind, I'm thinking how I need more stuff, but I tend to
overdo things. Okay. I think this plate's pretty good. Getting hungry just talking about it. What about you guys? I know some of you prefer just sounds without all the extra talking. And I could go either way. I love just chatting. I'm also fine just being silent. But this request did ask for soft speaking along with the glove sounds, which is why I'm rambling on. Hopefully I'm talking about enough mindless things that it won't really bother you guys too much, that like the silence. Hopefully you can just drown me out. So yeah, that's my brunch party. I'll have some champagne for mimosas and anything else. I'm not much of a drinker, so I told my friends that food is provided for them. And if they want to bring juice or a drink, that's great. I'm also going to have some tea, as you can tell with these teacups. I'm just going to have a hot green tea, which is what the teacups would be for. And I'm going to make some iced peach black tea. And I'll lightly sweeten it, I think. And that should be nice. Stomach rumbling. I'm getting real hungry. Okay. So we're making some progress. I think this video is going to be a longer one because I still have 11 plates to wash and 6 cups. I feel like we're only halfway through. I could always cut some of this out, but I think people tend to like longer videos. Depending on the content, I like longer videos. If it's a role play, 20 to 30 minutes is fine for me. Sometimes an hour-long role play can be a little excessive. Guys' favorite breakfast foods or brunch foods. Breakfast slash brunch is my favorite type of meal. I love it so much. I like pancakes and waffles and French toast. I like breakfast sandwiches. As a vegan, breakfast sandwiches are usually tofu, tempeh, different types of greens or veggies, avocado, some tasty veggie spreads, sprouts, I love sprouts. Running out of space here. Imagine the sponge is going to get really gross. just turn it into a bathroom sponge, which I'll use to clean the tub and the sink until that gets too frozen. I just throw it out. Although this is a new sponge, so it's a shame to have to get rid of it so soon. It's good to change your sponges now and then, because they do tend to harbor a lot of bacteria. You can always spray bleach on them. Or I know people microwave them. I don't have a microwave. You can also boil it in hot water, and that'll help. Start stacking my plates so I have more space. Okay. Let's see what I have here. Still have these guys, which are so cute. So now we've got our big plates. They're a little sticky around the edges, but this part's fine. I'll do my best in the description to sort of let you know. You're tired of plates and you're ready for cups. I can tell you when to move on to cups. Really, I just have to get this edge. I like cleaning videos. I really love Softly Sherry. Her name is Sherry. I guess I'm friendly with her on YouTube. I subscribe to her and I think she subscribed back to me. I know she commented on one of my videos once. But I enjoy her videos. She doesn't really make ASMR videos much anymore. But she still has some of her videos up on her channel. And it's called Softly Sherry. She does a lot of podcasts now. I do need them. I can't just grab them because they're really gross. So at least they'll be clean and ready. And that'll be good. Anyway, I got sidetracked, but Softly Sherry. Sorry about the sirens, guys. She has like 4 or 5 cleaning videos. They're like her most popular ones. They're really good. They have really great sounds. And she has a really beautiful, soothing voice. I can't tell if that noise... No, it's sticky, okay. I couldn't tell if it was just... sponge, or I'm pretty sure the edges are still sticky. It's a little hard to tell, to be honest, what's the design and what's like stickiness. It might just be the design at this point. Tell you what videos I have coming up, because usually I pre-record my videos and they get uploaded a week or two later, but this one I'm actually recording. I'm going to upload it tomorrow. I'm going to try to have a regular uploading schedule where every week I upload a new video, probably on Thursday, since that's kind of the trend I've started already for myself. Are so dirty and sticky that they're making my face dirtier. Like the bottom seems dirty too. Really get in there. I can feel my belly wanting to growl again, so apologize if you hear any of that growling. Okay, how many more plates? 5 more plates to go. Actually probably longer because I have a little bit of an intro, so a nice long video for those of you who like long videos. I feel like people will watch the first 15 minutes of this video and be like, okay, I had my fill. That's great. Maybe I'll just do 1 or 2 cups. I probably don't need to wash all the cups on camera. I'm going to be looking to upload 4 videos a month, 1 video a week. That's kind of my goal. So I have this video, which was requested a while back, which is why I'm kind of rushing it. I also have a request for an accent video. I'll just be reading things off of a book and speaking with some kind of made-up accent. I have a massage video, a guided meditation video. I definitely have more requests written down somewhere, but as always, guys, continue to give me your requests. I love making videos that you guys want to see. Is this clean enough yet? I hope so. Stages. And I'm actually not subscribed to too many people. I used to be subscribed to a lot, but, and I imagine people do this for my videos as well. So you subscribe to someone because you like a video of theirs, 1 or 2, but, you know, they upload videos and either the thumbnail or the title or the concept doesn't really catch your attention. You just kind of don't watch it when it comes into your feed. So I had a lot of people like that that I subscribed to for one of their videos, and I never really watched any of the other videos. I feel kind of bad, so I went about the month subscribing, which I'm sure people do to me too. I feel like I should support more artists and be subscribed and stay subscribed. But it just kind of clogs up my feed a bit with videos that I know I'm not going to watch anyway, so. But I would say probably Mall ZD is one of my favorites. I know that some people can be kind of controversial about her, I guess. I don't know if that's really true. She mostly just gets a lot of intense comments. But I love her. I think she's has a great sense of humor. She's really friendly. I wouldn't say I'm friends with her, but, you know, we've exchanged a couple messages or comments back and forth here and there. She follows me back on Instagram, so I feel pretty cool about that. She's commented on just one of my videos, which always feels nice. I've also had ASMR Angel comment on one of my videos, and the Water Whispers, and Danny. Well, Danny, I feel like I'm kind of friends with Danny Docile. I love his channel. He's not even, like, super big, but he is to me. He's, like, one of my favorites, so whenever he comments, I get really excited. But I've, like, chatted with him on Facebook here and there, so. But yeah, I always feel cool when a bigger ASMR artist comments on something of mine. It's always a nice feeling. So yeah, I really do like Amal. I know she's a very popular one anyway, but I just, something about her videos, especially lately, I just can watch them over and over again. And just kind of get obsessed with them. Gentle Whispering, of course. Although I tend to like her older videos more, I guess. I get soap everywhere. Who else? I also like, I mean, I like a lot of, Tarot Card Reader ASMR. I really, really like her videos. She has this lovely accent. It's really calming, and I just like her tarot card readings. They're really interesting, really trigger-inducing. I got lucky, and I was drawn for one of her free readings on Facebook. She made a video, and it was answering some of my questions, which was really nice. And I really hope this video is relaxing, because this is taking like an hour out of my day, which I'm not complaining. I probably would have taken this long to wash this stuff anyway, but I might have been like watching a TV show in the background. You know, I sound like such a brat. Real artists who make those fancy role plays spend like all day filming them. This is just an hour out of my day, but I'm a big multitasker. So I like to be doing a few things at once. I guess technically I'm filming a video and cleaning, so. Okay, so I'm gonna move on to the cup now. This cup is super dirty. I'm gonna start with the sponge and see. Do from there. It's been soaking for a little bit too, so it's really cute. Little teacup. Really get the outside of it. I feel like I already cleaned a teacup. Oh, I did clean a teacup. One of my first things was a teacup. Oh well. Here's another. This one's a really dirty one, though. It's actually not too bad since I soaked it. Just gonna really be a little aggressive about it, so I apologize if it's not super calming. But hopefully that's just kind of like the sounds. So thirsty. I wish I had my glass of water near me, but I don't. I just realized I think that my gloves are making things dirtier. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, guys. I think that I'm going to have to clean these without my gloves on. Because my gloves have collected all that nasty grime. Unless I, like, bleach them and then bring them back in. I'm making it dirtier with my glove. Anytime my glove hits it, it's adding extra dirt. So, you know what? We're at 40 minutes, right? This is what we're gonna do. Put that guy down. We're gonna play with the gloves. So, if the dishwashing sounds are getting boring, and by the way, I keep saying we're at 40 minutes, but we're probably gonna be longer. Because there is an intro. Make a little note about where to listen to the love sounds. Alright, well, I'm going to end this video. Washing these, but I'm gonna do it without the gloves. And I think over 30 minutes of washing dishes is probably enough of a trigger for you guys. So that's the video. Thank you for watching, guys. I really hope I fulfilled your request for the subscriber who wanted these dishwashing gloves. I was kind of distracted while I wash the dishes, so I don't know if it's making exactly the right sounds you're looking for. I hope so, otherwise we've got a 45 minute video with 5 minutes of glove sounds, but hoping it was a trigger either way. So thank you everyone else for watching. As always, please leave your requests below. And I'll talk to you very soon.